Good morning. What is God's judgment against false gods? Our reading today takes us to Jeremiah chapter 10, verses 11 through 16. Thus you shall say to them, the gods that have not made the heavens and the earth shall perish from the earth and from under these heavens. He has made the earth by his power, he has established the world by his wisdom, and has stretched out the heavens at his discretion. When he utters his voice, there is a multitude of waters in the heavens, and he causes the vapors to ascend from the ends of the earth. He makes lightning for the rain, he brings the wind out of his treasuries. Everyone is dull-hearted, without knowledge. Every metalsmith is put to shame by an image, for his molded image is falsehood, and there is no breath in them. They are futile, a work of errors. In the time of their punishment they shall perish. The portion of Jacob is not like them, for he is the maker of all things, and Israel is the tribe of his inheritance. The Lord of hosts is his name. So what is God's judgment against false gods? Well, he creates, and they do nothing. He is truth, they are lies. He creates. He created the universe. He stretched out the skies. He established the world by his wisdom. In contrast, the idol is lifeless. It's made by a man. The metalsmith forms it. It has no breath. It has no life. The metalsmith pretends it's a god, but it's a lie. It's a pretense. You know, basically, there's Jesus, and then there's everything else. The Father and the Holy Spirit are like Jesus in character, and so when we've seen Jesus, John 14, when we've seen Jesus, we've seen a representation also of the Father and of the Holy Spirit. If they were in his shoes, they would do exactly what he did. But an idol is a lie from the start. It's an excuse to exalt a different standard than Jesus. In fact, you could say it's Antichrist. An idol is Antichrist by its nature. It is a replacement, and a much lower one at that. Now for us, the God who actually is God, he is our portion. He who calls us, he who created us, invites us to join his family and join us in service to others. The other option is self-interest and self-serving. Jeremiah looked around himself only to see a nation pretty much given over to idolatry and self-service. It must have been very discouraging for a man trying to be spiritual like Jeremiah. And this word from God must have been particularly encouraging for him. God would win out in the end. God was still the God of Israel. He was still the portion. He was still the portion of Israel in spite of her adventures in idolatry. God had not abandoned her. God is long-suffering with us. He wants us in his family. He wants us in his army. He's waiting for you. What's taking you so long? Let's make sure we're enlisted, and let's pray to him. Dear Father in heaven, we want to be right. You made this world. You have a place for us in this world, a place for us in your plan. We've been very stubborn. We've tended to go off and do our own stuff. We've participated in a lot of sideshows. Lord, help us to worship you, the true God. Help us to find our way through the forest of idols, idolatries, self-serving pieces, and our own inclinations to serve ourselves, and help us to find the pathway you have for us, Lord, so that we can be your unique children, but also serving Jesus and helping and being part of your blessing to others. Help us, Lord, to be right. Thank you for hearing our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God's judgment against the false gods is the most devastating that it could be. He just simply tells it like it is. These are false. They're not even real personal beings. They're just false. He will end them. But in the meantime, they provide clarification about who's seeking to serve self and who's willing to serve others. God be with you today, and you be a blessing to others for Jesus.